Folks, welcome to the second part of this series, and welcome to our Hope Church virtual gathering. I really hope that you enjoy these online services. Today, our gospel reading is from John chapter 20, from verses 19.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the disciples were together, with the doors locked for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and side. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. Again, Jesus said, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you." And with that, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone's sins, their sins are forgiven. If you do not forgive them, they are not forgiven." Now, Thomas, also known as Didymus, one of the 12, was not with the disciples when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the nail marks in his hands, and put my finger where the nails were, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. Though the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here. See my hands. Reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe." Thomas said to him, "My Lord and my God." Then Jesus told him, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." Jesus performed many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not recorded in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing, you may have life in his name.
Thank you.
Exploring the story of Thomas, also known as Didymus, I was struck by a profound realization that Didymus means twin in Greek. And this notion of Thomas having a twin sparked a deeper reflection within me. It dawned on me that we all have a twin within us, a Didymus of our own. It's like we are walking around with two versions of ourselves. One that has incredible faith, incredible joy, and another that hesitates to believe and walk in the shadow of doubt. Now, this isn't about a sibling or a physical likeness, but about the duality that resides within each one of us. Now, this twin we are talking about isn't about sibling or a physical likeness, but about the duality that resides in each one of us. You see, inside each of us, there's a struggle going on, kind of like our very own inner Thomas that's doubting, that's questioning, that wrestling with the whys and what ifs. And in our lives, we often find ourselves wearing masks, those woven with smiles and nods and saying, you know what, I'm fine. But these masks serve as an armor against the world, shielding our vulnerabilities and our doubts and our fears from the prying eyes. An exterior that's very polished, composed, and seemingly unbreakable. All the while, masking the turmoil that runs deep within us. However, these masks we wear and the walls we build do not comes without a cost. Sometimes it distances us from a genuine relationship and from the joy of being known and accepted for who we truly are. This twin sometimes wonder, why God? Is God even real? Especially during the tough times, echoing Thomas's demand for a tangible proof of Jesus's resurrection. It's recognizing that our doubts and fears are a part of being a human. They don't negate our faith. Rather, they offer us a chance to engage with it more deeply with Jesus. So, you may ask this question, how then, Josh, can I reconcile with my inner twin, with my inner Didymus? First, by acknowledging our doubts as a part of our faith journey, not as failures. A theologian, Frederick Buchner, wisely notes this. Doubts are the ants in the pants of faith. They keep it awake and moving. Our doubts push us to seek deeper, to question, and to ultimately find more profound truth. Secondly, there's an opportunity for us to immerse ourselves in prayer, seek help from our church. If you really are going through a struggle, please do contact us in this very address or call us. Ask God in prayer where God can reveal himself to you. So as we draw near to him, he draws near to us. And he comforts us through our doubts with his presence. Finally, we trust. Trust in the character of God, in his promises, and in the stories of those who have walked before us. Thomas's story reminds us that faith is not about seeing, but believing in what we cannot see. As Jesus said to Thomas, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. But blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." Let this be our guiding verse. We are those blessed ones called to believe without seeing. So to everyone wrestling with their inner twin, know this: your doubts, your questions, and your fears do not define your hopes. In a world that is craving tangible proof, our faith stands as a beacon of hope, a declaration that even in our doubts, we choose to believe. If you're struggling today, again, call us or email us to this very address, and we will be very happy to pray for you. Your doubts do not disqualify your faith. They deepen it. Like Thomas, may you move from skepticism to declaring, "My God, my Lord, not because I have seen, but because I have believed." As we reflect on this incredible story of Thomas, let us now hear a good song, "Show Us Christ." Thank you for meeting us in spite of our doubts, for understanding our inner struggles, our inner twin, and for guiding us back into faith. Help us to embrace our questions as a pathway to a deeper understanding with Jesus, our Savior. Amen. May the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon you and remain with you, both now and forever. Amen.